Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we want to send a notification remotely using Firebase. In the previous session, we learned how to create notifications locally and on a schedule. Now we want to send a notification remotely using the React Native Push Notification module. We got acquainted with this module in the previous session. If you have not watched it, do these things. Using this command, you can install the module. And if you do this in Android, apply these changes to Android files. Now we will make these changes to send notification remotely. First, in this pass, we add the Google Services dependency. Then, in this pass, we add the Firebase dependency. We also add this line to the beginning of the build.gradle file. Next, we need to copy the googleservices.json file in this pass. We need to download this file from the Firebase console and put it in this folder. So we go to the Firebase console and create a new project there. Enter the project name, and if this is not a unique name will be generated as the project ID. Well, let's move on. Here, because our focus is on sending notifications, we disable this option, which is related to adding analytics to the project. Now we create the project and wait for it to build. Well, then we enter the project console. From the left side, we enter the Engage section and the Cloud Messaging option. Because our goal is to send notifications on Android, from here we define an Android app on the project. In this section, you must enter the name of your Android app package. This name can be found in the Android manifest file. In this section, we enter a custom name. And we will pass this part, which is optional here. Well, now the googleservices.json file is ready, and we can move it to the app folder. Download the file from here, and copy it into the app folder. Well, in the next step, we will refer to the settings that we have already made and don't need to change them. And then we enter the project console again. Now go to the Android folder in the terminal and sync the Gradle with this command. This will add dependencies to the Android project. Now go back to the project folder and run the app. Now we can send our first message. This warning is about adding analytics, which is not important to us here. Enter the message title here. And as you can see on the right, you can see the preview of open and closed notification. In this section, we enter the main text of the message. Here we can optionally enter the address of an image that is displayed next to the message. I use the Firebase logo as an example. In the open and closed mode, the notification is displayed as follows. Here we choose a name of our choice for the notification. This name is not displayed to the user and is only used to manage notifications on the console. Well, in the next step, we have to select an app in the project. In the next step, we can specify the delivery schedule to be immediate or on a specific date. The next step is completely optional. For example, we can enter the name of our desired notification channel. We can send the value with the key along with the notification to use it in the background. We can enable or disable the notification sound. And we can also specify how long this message will expire. Well, now let's review it once and publish the notification. Now we go to the app and wait for the notification to be received. As you can see, the notification was received correctly. Now if in the index.js file you have made the configs correctly, by clicking on the notification, you can see the content of its object in the console. Also in the Firebase console, you can see the statistics related to your sent notification after a while. So there we go, we learned how to send a notification remotely using Firebase. So in the next video, we will use another Google services, Google Map. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next session.